Spring has finally sprung. This plum bush is in front of our house, and not only does it have leaves on it, but it's also in full blossom. Last week was my dad's 86th birthday. On Sunday, my siblings and about half of our families came into town to celebrate. On the way home from Mom and Dad's, we stopped at a brand new gelato store in Castle Rock. It's over by the outlet mall. Overall, it was really good. We will be back for sure. Welcome to town. One of the windiest days we've had in years, and just to update you on the greenhouse, I think everything's holding together pretty good.
Hanging out in the dark theater.
And if you aren't advertising on the largest cinema
sound,
platform in the country, you're missing
we're not seeing
the most
anything,
diverse,
so
attentive, and influential audience
so,
around.
Here we go.
Let
hopefully
NCM
it's a movie.
Get your message in front of them on this screen and beyond.
So we finally got visuals as well, but sadly they never were able to fill the screen. A little disappointing. Luckily, it's a good movie that's worth seeing. All right, so everybody's uploaded their contribution. So we open up Visual Studio, we click on start, hopefully. Oh no. Compiling. And our executable's over here. Got a random false word over here. We'll figure out what that means. But we can host and unhost, we can change our host IP address. We can click on join, we can still type in our name. We can change our player's color, we can change our player's type number, we can start the game. Game over, we ran out of life support. Last week on Saturday, I put together my Backflow and was pretty happy with it. Sunday when I turned it all on, had a bunch of different leaks throughout the system. I do still have a little drip going on here, but that should be pretty quick and easy to fix. So looks like I'm ready to turn the sprinklers on.
I read The Honeys by Ryan LaSala for book club, and it was definitely an interesting read, not my norm in several categories. It was about a character named Mars who is gender fluid, and the pronouns that they used for Mars were he, so we'll just go with that. And Mars has a twin sister, and the book starts with her kind of attacking him and then being killed in the process. So it was definitely a jarring beginning. And then he has to go to camp and figure out what happened to her. I thought it was going to be more of a mystery, but it turned into kind of a horror book. I'm not really sure. The writing was excellent, and I felt like the character was really intriguing. I felt like there were so many good things about it. I wouldn't recommend it to everybody, but it was a good book. And yet there were definitely some parts toward the end where I was like, okay, did I miss something? What just happened? So anyway, I I thought it was a good book, and for book club, it was a great discussion. So, The Honeys by Ryan LaSala.
At Melissa's book club, her friend Ray had a special unboxing with a book that he'd won in a contest.
Yes! Here we go.
Oh,
this, okay. This ravenous thing.
This ravenous thing.
So you didn't know what you won?
No.
You enter so many of them, you just didn't know which
exactly.
one was coming.
While Melissa was at book club, I was at the final band concert of the year. One special moment in the concert was that when saying goodbye to the seniors, the past band director, Chet Aliga, stopped in to help with the festivities. Chet also got to conduct the senior piece this year.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our senior class.
On Thursday, we had our final assembly of the year. It is a farewell to the seniors, but also includes the moving up of all the classes in the gym as well. And finally, the incoming freshman class comes in on a field trip from Mesa Middle School to fill their new spot in the high school gym as well.
Our freshman leadership class of 2025, 26, 27, and 2028! Take a high road, everyone. Please take care of each other. And Ryan Husky!
It was Teacher Appreciation Week this week as well. I don't have much footage because unfortunately this year there wasn't too much to show.
So because the last book I was reading was a little on the horror side, I needed to read something else at night, so that I could sleep. And so I started The Iron Knight by Julie Kagawa. It's the fourth one in the Iron Fae series. And I don't know if you remember, I didn't love the first book, and the second book was a little better, and the third book was much better. This one I liked probably the most so far. It was just kind of a different perspective, and it was the perspective of Prince Ash as he decides to travel to the end of the world so that he can win a soul, and then he can be reunited with his love, Megan. So he is a fairy, a fae, and he does not have a soul, and it was an interesting story. I thought it was, again, like the series has just gotten better, so that's great. And kind of on the tail end of that, I was reading it on Hoopla, and there was a novella that was included, and that was for The Iron Prophecy. So, also by Julie Kagawa, it was kind of a shorter story that was up after Ash travels to the end of the world, then about a prophecy that gets spoken about his and Megan's son, sorry, spoiler alert, and so then they're trying to figure out if there's anything they can do about it. It was a neat story, a novella for sure, not fully fleshed out, but having read the other books in this series, I felt like it was just an interesting thing to keep reading. I would say that the Iron Fae series has definitely grown on me, and so we'll have to see what next book I come up with from there.